the graviton is the particle we use to describe what would be a quantum theory of gravity. And there is a long-standing issue in fundamental physics, which is that we have no idea how to link quantum mechanics, which explains our understanding of the small-scale physics, to gravity, which is a very... All of the experimental observations we have about gravity are large-scale phenomena in the universe. So finding the graviton will mean gluing together those two very different scales and those two very fundamental questions of physics. Quite a difficult question because, as I was saying, there is no real clue, real hint of how to make a quantum counterpart of the gravitational theory. It's a spin two particle. So those are very specific properties. The spin two one is a very, very particular property in the sense that we don't have any other elementary particle that is spin two. So it makes it very, very particular, very specific.
There is one big remaining piece of the puzzle that is not there in the standard model of particle physics. This is gravity. One of these questions, one of those problems, is what we call the hierarchy problem of the standard model. And this hierarchy problem can be boiled down essentially to one simple question. So there is a huge, there is 16 order of magnitude between the scale at which we need to have the weak interaction to explain processes, to explain physics, and the scale at which we need gravity, quantum gravity, to explain physics. So there is a 16 order of magnitude that are not understood whatsoever. Nobody can answer the question of why are those two scales so different.
We have models that are trying to find, to explain the presence of gravity at a lower energy scale, at the energy scale we are able to probe at the LHC. The most popular one is of course the one where you introduce extra dimensions. So the basic principle here is that gravity is not, the scale of the at which gravity appears is not actually so far away from the other fundamental interaction of the standard model of particle physics, but somehow it's diluted by the presence of extra dimensions. So gravity is allowed to go in a wider space, and therefore what we see in our boring standard 4D space is only a representation of gravity, and therefore it appears weaker to us.
Extra dimension models are trying to tackle these problems straight away, like just trying to address them directly by saying, by claiming that no, actually the two scales are way closer to each other, but the gravity appears weaker in our 4D time space because it's diluted by the presence of the extra dimensions. We know that it's hard, we can hardly fit any extra dimension that are very large in the context of including the weak interaction in those extra dimensions. So given this fact, given how well we know the electroweak interaction, additional dimensions, space dimensions, will either have to be very, very tiny, so very small, so it's a modification, another view of the space, which includes very tiny extra dimensions, or you could make those extra dimensions a bit larger by allowing only the gravitational field that you didn't observe yet to go to those. So in most of those extra dimension models, what we happen to do is like we add an extra dimensions to the current space. So typically it's usually what we call a wrapped extra dimension, which is essentially a closed one, so a bit more complex topology than what we are used to work with. And we confine, we forbid all of the standard model field to go into those extra dimensions. The only one that is allowed is the gravity, the graviton field. So if we find a graviton at the LHC, what do we mean for physics? Well, it's huge, right? It would be a big thing. And I guess by finding a graviton at the LHC, what you're meaning is finding a new fundamental particle that would be a spin true particle, which has never been observed before. So that would be probably one of the most interesting scenarios we could be in. Recently, with this excess that both the ATLAS and CMS collaboration are seeing, around 750 GeV in the diphoton spectrum, which is totally unexpected. We have no hint of what this can be. So if this is a graviton, it's probably the most exciting situation.